Hey guys, welcome back to Charms. I know I was missing in action for a couple of weeks. Sorry about that. I'm back with some super fun and colorful festive DIYs for this Diwali. Hope you guys like it. I'm going to make a Diwali series which will include many easy DIY ideas for this festive season. This is the first project from the series. Without any further delay, we'll get started. We would need foam sheets for this project, so I have taken a lavender and a pink sheet. Measure 7 cm with the help of a ruler and mark the points on the foam sheet. I'm marking it on the top and the bottom to get a perfect straight line. Now we are going to divide the whole width into 2, that is 7 by 2, which is 3.5 cm. Once dividing that 2 sections, you have to mark 3.5 cm along the length of the foam sheet. Now you get squares with 3.5 cm into 3.5 cm dimension. I have taken a chart paper and drawn a flower on it, and I have cut along the drawing. Now this makes a stencil for us. I have placed it on the foam sheet and marked along the stencil we have made. Now just cut along the lines you have drawn. Take an iron box and keep it in medium heat. Press the foam flowers onto the base. Keep it for a few seconds and you can see that the petals shrink up. Shape the petals before it cools down. Can you see the difference between the size of the flowers? The more amount of heat you apply to the foam, the more it shrinks up. So you can shape it accordingly as per your desire. Press each petal of the flower to the base of the heat iron and shape it up to give a pointed edge to the petals. Repeat the same process to all of the petals and all of the flowers. See the difference between the two flowers I made? You can use any of the models I have shown you. I personally prefer the pointed end petals. I'll just show you why I'm using the heat technique to make the pointed ends. As you can see, I'm making the shape of the petal without heating it and it does not retain the shape. But when applied heat, it just retains the shape. Look how beautifully the flowers turned out. Now take a sharp blade and cut the center of the flower in the form of a X. You can see that there is a vertical line and a horizontal line. The last step is to take a fairy light and insert all these flowers one by one onto the lights. The light acts as a pollen to the flower, and look how cute it turned out. Insert alternate colors. With this technique, you can see that the flowers are removable. This is one technique of fixing the flowers onto the lights. We are going to reach the best part of this project and look how beautiful it turned out. Now the next technique is to insert a flower on top of another flower. Use alternate colors in this technique as well. Once you insert everything, it looks something like this, and with lights on, it looks stunning. There you go, you have a beautiful fairy light decorated with the cute foam flowers, and I'm sure this will look beautiful on your walls or on the doorway or any place wherever you hang this. I hope you guys like it. Stay tuned for more such creative and beautiful decor ideas for this Diwali. Do subscribe to my channel for more such videos and click on the bell icon to get updates on the new videos uploaded. Thanks for watching, guys. Do support me and wish you guys a happy and safe Diwali.